What's going on, guys? It's Melt here, and welcome back to another episode of the F1 2021 My Team Crane Road, episode number 6 here for the Azerbaijan
We've
Grand
got an
Prix. If
issue
you did miss
with
the
my
last
game,
episode,
possibly.
it was at Monaco for the Monaco Grand Prix. It's where it's held. Some a pretty stale race as far as Monaco goes, you know. Can't overtake it, that circuit, like,
Thanks
at
for
all.
dealing with
The
that.
walls are never more than
Department's
like 10
appreciated.
feet away. So we did score our third points finish on the bounce. Some late race drama, fending off Fernando Alonso and I think a McLaren of Daniel Ricciardo. But now we are here in Azerbaijan, circuit very famous for its long straights. Hopefully we could, hopefully we can keep our points streak going. Currently sat P12 in the standings and. Yeah, don't know how we're gonna go at Baku because of the long straights. It's a very draggy car we have at the moment, but yeah, that's it, and let's get to the race weekend. So here we are in qualifying, about to start our first flying lap, not on a street circuit we had at Monaco last round, but we've gone a bit deep into turn one, locked that front left tyre just a little bit, and we just did the same in turn two as well, gone a bit wide at the apex as we struggle a little bit for traction on the exit, but we picking up some good speed down the straight. I was talking about our drag being fairly poor, but it's not actually as bad as we expected as we come through the castle section, infamous castle section, and we send it. Don't think we can get much closer to the walls than we have there. Very, very tidy, but once again, just struggling for that rear traction, so that could be something we're going to need to just iron out of the cars. We come across the line for a 40.2 ahead of Schumacher and Latifi, and we'll watch Jack Aitken cross the line now, who goes P18, about half a tenth behind us, so. You know, us two showing pretty similar levels of pace, which is promising, but we are going to go for our second run in Q1, and we did make the same mistake in turn one, but turn two, we just didn't lock that front left, and the lap is just so much tidy as we're going to come through the castle section for a second time, cut that inside curb a bit more. We lose time on the initial exit, but as we get the power down, we do gain it back. A lot more conservative through the castle than we did on the first lap, because I don't think we could have sent it much harder and we probably would have just risked damage. But we come on for a 40.0, and are we out of Q1? No, we are not, by barely half a tenth there. So, you know, maybe if we just sent it a little bit harder through that castle section, we might have been into Q2, but, you know, not a lot we can do now, so let's get to the grid for the start of the race.
A warm welcome to all of you watching at home to today's Azerbaijan Grand Prix, and a race that in its short history has already proven no stranger to drama. A fourth row start is just about as likely to give you a podium as a pole position would. And remember, in 2017 and 2018, both Lance Stroll and then Sergio Perez took surprise podiums here. It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he starts from pole position. And it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Ricciardo, Lando Norris, and Perez, Sainz, Leclerc, Gasly, and Yuki Tsunoda, Vettel, Fernando Alonso, Lance Stroll, and Ocon, Raikkonen, Giovinazzi, the owner driver, and Jack Aitken, Russell, Mick Schumacher, Latifi, and Nikita Mazepin. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head to trackside for today's race.
After the points finish last race, let's aim to keep the momentum going.
And we are going to try to keep that momentum going, Jeff, but we're starting in P17, so not looking the best for us already this weekend. It's going to be a two-stopper as Taiwa is surprisingly high around Baku, but we are now going to get ready for the five lights for the Azerbaijan Grand Prix, and it's a lights out and we are racing in Azerbaijan. Jovanac getting a really slow start there. We've got so much second phase wheel spin there, going into turn one, keeping it nice and tidy on the outside line, not trying to get claimed by anyone if someone's backwards or anything. But now going into turn two, it's all very claustrophobic. We are side by side with our teammate Jack Aitken, and we're gonna just get him round the outside, carrying more speed, get the power down on the exit, and now tuck into the slipstream of Giovinazzi. And in to turn three we go, and that is, oh, Kimi Raikkonen has hit the back of Lance Stroll now, so we are Giovinazzi's going slow because of that. Can we get past Giovinazzi? Not quite yet. We nearly drive right into the back of Kimi, and we're now side by side with the man who's lost his front wing into the chicane. We get that done, and now we can use this as an opportunity to pull away while everyone behind is stuck behind Kimi. And I doubt they would have got past before the castle section, because there's just no space at all. Now we're on lap three, the race being pretty still, just a bit of a slipstream fest there, which is fairly surprising because Azerbaijan has long straights, heavy braking zones, so that's basically the recipe for overtaking, as we're going to line up and overtake on Lance Stroll here. Now we're going to break at the 100, send it down the inside, get to the apex first, leave him the space, and that was a lovely little dive bomb there into turn three. And we're now on the chase of Sebastian Vettel and Esteban Ocon, while we both have DRS. I do have the double slipstream. Gonna move to the inside again, dive bomb him into turn one. We may be getting a little bit of a habit for dive bombing Aston Martins from this race alone, but no, he's gonna fight back into turn two. He's gonna go back up the inside. Can we keep it round the outside? Yes, we can, and we do have DRS from Esteban Ocon, which will help us defend. But are we going to be able to defend? Is he going to stay behind us? Yes, he is. So both Aston Martin's been very sensible here, just obviously playing the long game. But we're on a charge. We want to get back into the points as we are coming to the end of lap six here behind the two Alpines. We're in an Aston Martin and Alpine sandwich now, through the fast left-right, which is very bad if you get wrong. We've got slipstream of Ocon right down the straight, about 200 miles an hour there or thereabouts. We get right up his gearbox, pull to the inside, and hopefully out-drag him right down this straight into turn one, move back across to the racing line, and he's probably going to line up another move, but he does not have the DRS, so he couldn't, as we do get a little bit loose on that chicane there. And now lap 7, we are going to box, and there you go, Yuki Tsunoda has just retired from the Grand Prix. Obviously just maybe an engine issue, so he's Honda Power. Hopefully that's not a worry for our engines, as right at the end of the pit lane here, hopefully it's a slick stop, but we have front wing damage. So obviously we really didn't feel that damage, but apparently it was there, so now we have to make up about 6-7 seconds there. We're going to need to close that gap of what we have lost in these next two stints, as Giovinazzi's now having a little go at us, as we're just going to cover off the inside line. We take the optimal racing line, but never mind, I got that wrong. We do let him by, actually, around turn one, and the detection point just before turn two here, so we are going to play the long game, not fighting too much, hopefully not lose a time, and get the DRS and slipstream on him into turn two. But it's looking like it's going to get closer. He moves to the inside to defend, but we do keep it nice and tidy, and has hit the wall. Giovinazzi has hit the wall on the inside. We did leave him plenty of space there, so that may be just I would say a rookie mistake, but I think this is second, third year in F1 in this career mode. But now we've skipped all the way from lap 8 to lap 17. All the positions that we have gained at this point are from people making pit stops, so like I said, very still races. We just send up the inside of Ocon into the pit lane. So that was a very ballsy move. Now we are hopefully going to get a quick pit stop this time. Hopefully no front wing damage. I have not clipped anything this stint. And no, there is no front wing damage. Are we going to be out ahead of the Alpine? We just got held in a little bit there. And yes, we are just ahead of the Alpine as we clobber that curb on the pit exit. And there is Lance Stroll, the man we overtook in the first stint. We're going to go left, fake back to the right. But no, he's going to keep it up the inside of us. We are now side by side through turn three, and Esteban Ocon right on the gearbox of Lance Stroll there. So going side by side, really not helping us, and we are still side by side going in to the chicane, and Lance Stroll has just got us out on the brakes there. So some really good racing between the two of us, but we do have slipstream and DRS. We're gonna fake, go left, fake right, go back to the left, move back onto the racing line, secure P12 for now, unless he's gonna use DRS on the second straight, which in fact he is. I'm going to squeeze him to the outside the tiniest bit, move back on to the racing line. That was not Stroll, that was Ocon, sorry, as we have no traction on the exit there. And that did leave us a little bit vulnerable to Lance Stroll, but he did not go for a move. So, you know, at this point, battling these guys is hard. It looks like we're only aiming for a P12 in this race. But you know, up five positions, that's still a really good result compared to where we started. So it's nothing to say no to. Couldn't get my words out there. But yeah, we are going pretty well in this race. About three laps to go, as we've made a proper mess of that of turn two exit. As now Esteban Ocon is going to attack us into turn three. We're using our ERS down the straight, but has he got us in at two, turn three? No, he hasn't. We've got loose on the exit, and Lance Stroll. We collected Lance Stroll on our half spin there after we got really loose on that exit. So, you know, not a lot we could do there. We've made contact with Ocon in the same corner as well. So, you know, I think then again there, we are being very, very aggressive now. But, you know, we have held Esteban Ocon off. As Max Verstappen has won the race, so congratulations to him, and we've come home for a very, very nice P12.
Brilliant stuff from Red Bull today. What a superb victory. Anthony Davidson, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
I think that smart tyre management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
Red Bull are our winners today after showcasing some incredible driving. There's been a huge push from them lately to stay competitive with the other teams, and they're certainly proving themselves. Max Verstappen should be pleased with his performance, making gains at the top of the table. Let's focus on the driver of the day. Anthony Davidson, who do you pick?
I'm going to give it to the owner driver today. They fought so hard and had incredible pace at times, so I don't think anyone else did a better job today.
Let's move on to the constructors. Red Bull pull further ahead in the standings. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.
So, very fairly action-packed race there towards the end. The start, not so much. But before the video ends, I just do want to apologise for not uploading for the last probably month and a half. I think it is. I've not really got a good reason. Just haven't, you know, felt the motivation. But hopefully, I will be back with some more consistent upload now. But that is it for this My Team Career Mode. If you did enjoy, please leave a like, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.